So
I get a lot of questions asking me how I record my music and distribute it and get it out into like Spotify, Apple Music, iTunes, and even like my artist profiles, like my Spotify profile, how I'm like able to customize all that, everything about the process. So I figured today I would break it all down for you. I had you guys send me some questions. Also, I just want to say, like, I'm no expert at this. I have taught myself a lot. I'm just gonna go through beginning to end process of what I do. Equipment. Things that I use are my guitar. I own a Taylor 324 CEV class for a piano. I was just using like a Yamaha keyboard for the longest time, but now I have the Williams Allegro 388 weighted key digital piano. For the microphone that I use, I use the Rode NT1A mic. I really like it. I forget how much it is. I think it's like $200. It's not the cheapest, but compared to a lot of mics, it is like a really great price point. However, I also use the Tonar BM70, I believe, which is like $70, which is also a really great mic. And then also, you can get like USB condenser mics on Amazon. I use like a $15 USB mic on Amazon for Unlovable and Unlike You. I will link as much as I can in the description. Then cable wise, you're gonna need cables that fit to your devices depending on like what you use. As for recording interface, I use this Focusrite Scarlett Solo and I really like it. It's simple, easy to use. They have another one with like more input options, but I'm typically only recording with one instrument and one vocal. But yeah, you can get condenser mics that plug right into your computer so that you don't need a separate recording interface. And also, you don't need like expensive or a lot of equipment to make and release music. The first song that I ever released, Nice to Meet You, was a voice memo from my phone. You can like hear the chair creak in the beginning. Getting started, you do not need like all the equipment in the world, all the expensive stuff in the world. As far as recording interfaces go, I use Logic Pro X, which is compatible with all Apple devices, and I'm a really big fan of Logic Pro. Compared to a lot of recording softwares and programs, I think this is a really great price point. I know that it's not necessarily budget friendly, but if you are looking to invest something that's going to last for a long time, I'm a big fan of Logic Pro and I think it's a lot easier to use. However, I did used to use GarageBand, which is free on like every Apple device. You can even use it on the iPhone. And honestly, Logic Pro is just like the step up from GarageBand. It looks almost the exact same. It's just obviously costs more because you can do a lot more with it. But GarageBand, honestly, it's a really great option. I used GarageBand for Unlovable, Unlike You, Here's the Song You Asked For, Two Faces, like all the stuff you heard on my SoundCloud, like all of that was done on GarageBand. It slaps, so. But also, voice memo on your phone. Like you honestly don't even need a recording software. You can just take a voice memo on your phone if you're singing and playing. The options are endless. A big question I got was how to make your recording sound professional. This is not my greatest area of expertise by any means, because for Grieving and Can't Get You Off My Mind, I did have somebody produced them for me. Shout out Phil Sweeney. But something that is really helpful is vocal presets, and a lot of recording softwares have built-in vocal presets that you can use that are honestly really great, and they have a bunch of different options depending on like your mic, your voice, how you want to sound. I know Logic and GarageBand have almost all of the same like vocal presets. The one that I like a lot is called Natural Vocal. YouTube tutorials are so helpful, because even though you can buy plugins for Logic, the stock plugins that come with a lot of these recording programs are so good. For me, I created kind of like my own vocal preset. I'm still playing around with it. I just googled mixing vocals with stock Logic Pro plugins and I followed a YouTube video and then I made a preset out of it. It's really just about playing around with what you like. I don't have the greatest advice for making it sound super professional, because I still am working on that. YouTube has taught me a lot about recording and how to use things. As far as distribution, and I feel like this is where I get the most questions, there's a lot of ways you can go about this because there's a bunch of different like sites available. If you're new here, I burp in every video. If you're not new here, you're not surprised. I've been using TuneCore since 2015. I've thought about experimenting with other sites, but I like TuneCore. They've always been like very helpful, and I think their artist compensation is really great. But other sites that I know of and I have had friends use are CD Baby and DistroKid. I'm not too familiar with DistroKid, but for me the main difference between CD Baby and TuneCore is with TuneCore you pay $9.99 for a single and you can send it out to all digital stores. Exactly 1 year from the date you release it, you pay another $9.99. So it's like basically a fee every year of $9.99 to keep it up. However, it can kind of seem like a lot, the $9.99 year after year. But the thing I like about TuneCore is that you get to keep all of your streaming revenue. Whereas on CD Baby, it's a one-time fee, but they do take part of your revenue from streams and like people purchasing your music and stuff like that. The thing with the music is people don't buy music anymore, really. Like people still do, but it's now that streaming is the new way of listening to music, you don't get paid a lot for streams. I think it's worth paying a little more yearly to make sure you can be fairly compensated with your music. TuneCore, like I said, you can send it to all their available stores. You can also add like your lyrics and cover art and stuff like that. And if you don't know how to make your own cover art, like they even have an option to like make one for you, which is really cool. If you're not with a label or have a publishing deal, I think going through sites such as these is probably your best bet to distribute music. If there's another way that I don't know of, let me know. And then something I figured I would also touch on, just maybe it's like a tidbit if you guys were curious, is how payments go, at least in my experience with TuneCore. I forget how long it is, but it takes a few months to get your first payment, although I do know that TuneCore is working to compensate the artists a lot faster, which I think is really great, which is another reason that I love TuneCore. After the first payment, they do start coming. On average, I think after the first payment, it can be like a month to a month and a half before you get your next, and it becomes more regular. This isn't sponsored, but like TuneCore, if you're watching this. Something else I wanted to talk about, because it was another main question, is how I customize my Spotify profile and like my Apple Music profile, and basically how I get to like look at all the stats. For Apple Music for Artists, you do have to request and like claim your artist page. I forget the process of it, but it wasn't too hard. It did take a little bit of time, but once you're in, it's like easy to get things going, and then you can like submit your artist photo and it'll take a few days for them to like approve it. You can like look at statistics and stuff through the Apple Music app, and then there's also the website. The Apple Music app isn't terrible, but I fucking love the Spotify for Artists app. It is the best thing that ever happened to me. Promote your newest track, you can like really break down your statistics and streams and listeners. You can get alerted if your music is put on playlists. You can see the playlists that people add your music to. You can post photos and get yearly recaps. If this app is down the window, I'm trying to explain how to fucking use it. Well, a pro though to using CD Baby, if you were to take that route, is that you can automatically get verified with Spotify through CD Baby. But even if like you do use TuneCore or another service that they're not necessarily partnered with, you can still sign up to claim your artist profile and get verified. It might take a little bit longer, but it's still possible. You used to need to have a requirement of a certain amount of followers, but I don't think they do that anymore. They've made the process a lot easier for artists, so. Something else that I just thought of that I figured I would mention, when it comes to making cover art, it doesn't need to be like super professional and like edited and stuff like that. Like I'm not, like I get a lot of questions on how I make cover art for my songs, and I'm not kidding you, most has been taken on my iPhone. I'm just gonna say it, and I've edited it using like PixArt. You can like cut things out, and then the Photoshop app on my iPhone. I just recently like got this camera, I'm not kidding you. I've made 99% of my cover art on this phone. If you wanna like adjust the colors, I've used VSCOcam. You can also use Lightroom. Like, you can literally create a song and cover art on your phone. I just wanted to put that out there because I have done that so many times. So many times. I think I covered everything. If you guys have any more questions, like I said, feel free to leave them below or send me a message. Or if you have any tips, regarding any of this, feel free to leave them below. That's how I record and release my music as of the present moment. And I hope this was helpful. I know it can be like really scary to release music for the first time, but it's worth it. And I think if you know it's something you really want to do, I would just take the leap and do it. It does not matter the quality of your recording or anything like that. Like I said, my first release was a voice memo. For me, that was the bright first step. Because even though it didn't sound perfect and I got all in my head about it, it was still a step forward in the right direction. Don't get too caught up in the whole, but it needs to sound professional. I'm in a studio. No, use what you have. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful to you. Let me know what else you guys want to see. I am excited to share more music with you, and I will leave all my links down below. Yeah, I love you guys with my whole heart, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.